In 1992 was the first time I ever touched a computer, and I immediately began studying programming. But for several years before that, I played a lot of games on the NES and the Famicom. And in NES games, one of the most fascinating things to me were the password generators. I am Bisqwit, and in this series we are going to study how old games generated their passwords.
I'm going to kickstart this series with Mega Man 2. Incidentally, Mega Man 2 was for me the first game where I committed to decoding the password system, and I did it on my own. Let's try this one password that everyone remembers by their heart, I'm sure. In Mega Man 2, when you successfully enter a password, you get this screen that shows which things you acquired. There's P-Shooter, the 8 Robot Masters, and items 1, 2, 3. P-Shooter, however, is complementary and does not play a role in the password. You always have the P-Shooter. Item 1 comes automatically with Hitman, item 2 comes automatically with Airman, and item 3 with Flashman, so we can strike this out as well. But there is also the number of E-Tanks, which is saved in the password, even though it is not indicated on that screen. Not saved in the password are also the number of extra lives, the health and weapon energy bars, difficulty selection, and the current stage number. Let's see what we got. The 8 Robot Masters each are either beaten or not beaten. This means 1 bit of data per boss. The total number of energy tanks can be anything from 0 to 4. Expressing this number requires 3 bits of storage. This brings the total amount of data that must be somehow encoded in the password to 11 bits. The true amount of information is very slightly smaller, but it still rounds up to 11 whole bits. Now, when I was 12 years old, I knew nothing about bits and entropy and all that mathematics. Here's what I did. First, let's take a totally blank password from the game. The first observation we make is that the password has 9 dots. Then we acquire everything and generate a new password. This password too has 9 dots. So it cannot be a binary number, because that would require 11 dots. If we superimpose them, we can see that the two passwords are mostly different, but not completely. There are 3 dots that didn't change at all. Most curious. So I decided to go step by step, and I observed that when I clear Bubble Man, the dot from C3 moves to D1, and so on for all the bosses. And from my table I realized that every time I busted a boss, exactly one of those dots moved, as indicated by those arrows. Except one. The number of E-tanks had stayed 0, and the dot at A1 had stayed in place, so it was logical to assume that A1 means 0 E-tanks. But when I collected one E-tank and asked the game for a new password, yes, A1 did change, but so did everything else! Looking for patterns, I studied passwords with 2, 3 and 4 E-tanks, and I decided it's best to do the whole thing over from beginning, and this table was produced. Now there is a pattern here, if you look carefully. Each time the number of E-tanks increases, the coordinates for the rest of the bosses increases by 1. While you can totally ignore this detail if you have this table printed on paper, it is nice to know this table could technically be memorized without much effort. But at this point, the password system was completely decoded and one could both decode and generate any possible password supported by the game. I am Bisqwit. Stay tuned for the next time when we cover more games.